the venom obtained from a vampire spider.
Yes, I know.
I'm slowly beginning to doubt you.
Samantha did not sacrifice her life like that. If I were just to disregard everything that she fought for all this time.
My father saved me from vampires when I was a kid.
When did that happen?
About 14 years ago.
14 years had passed since then. It was my followers that killed your father.
Why can't you just free me from this misery right now?
Maybe this can vanquish the monster inside her for good.
Jake! Lord Sentinel, forgive me. I was the one who told Supremo where he could find Mateo and Leah back then.
I'm not angry with your mother. All of her life, she did nothing but fight for the people she loved. That's how you should remember her, Jake.
Lord Sentinel! It's Tristan. His video connection was cut off. The last footage showed him and Sandrino arguing.
Greta was able to
escape. Jake, we can't allow Greta to get anywhere ahead of us!
How you look at me right now, how much you hate me. That's how people around me look at me all the
time. That's why you chose to become evil.
Just like how you chose to hate all vampires.
It may not be too late for us, brother. Is it still possible to end this war?
Your ideas are like music to my ears.
The decision is yours. You can still change everything.
Tristan, where are you?
You betrayed me. I thought we were brothers, but you fooled me.
Malia, why did you guys come here?
Tristan, your mission is finished. I can kill Sandrino now.
I'm being reminded of the blood moon.
The prophecy is going to happen soon.
Why did he have to do such thing to me?
Because Tristan is the man with the cursed ink and the prophecy. He's the person fated to fight against the new chosen one, and not you.
If he's the one who will kill Malia, I need to turn him into a vampire immediately. And when that happens, I will rule over this world all by myself.
Given the strength Malia has shown, she could have easily defeated Supremo. But she wasn't there.
I'm sure Supremo's hiding now.
Well, Malia won't stop looking for him.
With what I'm going to do, you'll surely come out from hiding, Sandrino. So you can face me and your ultimate death.
Andre.
We're fighting so hard for everyone's sake. We're going to stop the evil that envelops this world once and for all. Eventually, Sandrino.
Today on Channel 6 News, we are coming to you live at a press conference of an expose about the corruption of presidential candidate Gilbert Imperial. It was reported that Mr. Imperial is involved in insurance fraud because he blew up his own business. Stay tuned for more on the story.
It's true, I used to work for Mr. Gilbert Imperial. I can no longer stomach what he's doing, it's too much. But he will not stop until he gets what he wants.
Mrs. Inta, can you please give us your statement?
Mr. Andre, Javier is one of our witnesses. We also want to say
that our agency is open to answer any other questions you may have.
Mrs. Inta,
you were Mr. Imperial's campaign strategist, but you've also witnessed his corrupt practices while you were working for him this whole time. Why did you decide to expose him?
Because I realized that my conscience can't bear to campaign for a person who doesn't have a heart, and who constantly lies to the people he supposedly wants to help just so he could get their votes.
Miss Magsaysay, is there something you'd like to say to Mr. Imperial?
Gilbert, there's no point in hiding from justice. Just accept all the consequences of the evil things you've done. Come out and face me already. And face what is destined to happen to you.
before you talked to the Luna Soldier, I went ahead and asked him where I can find Tristan. We searched all the places he mentioned. But Tristan wasn't in any of them.
Do a more thorough search, Elise. Those pesky mortals deliberately fooled me. So I'm sure they have other tricks up their sleeve, and also planned where to hide Tristan and his family. Do you have a problem with that?
No, beloved, it's a vampire.
I didn't hear you answer me. Do you have a problem?
It's just that we heard your heartbeat again, Supremo.
My heart may be beating, but I haven't lost my powers. And mark my words, I'll even be more powerful. When you find Tristan, bring him to me. So go out and search for him! You play this game well, Tristan. But you can't hide from me forever. I will find you eventually.
Supremo's followers can no longer be seen in SMV. The Luna soldiers also returned to all the locations of the killings, but there's been no trace of his followers.
And what about the campaign headquarters?
Preparations for the campaign are still ongoing. However, we heard from the people there that no one has seen him yet.
Any news on Greta?
I'm afraid we still haven't found our Lord Sentinel. Please forgive us.
I'm worried that Greta might go to Supremo and tell him where our headquarters is. Maybe that's what they're preparing for.
But he hasn't come to us yet, Father. He's not going to confront us now, because his heart continues to beat. It's his weakness.
And the successive killings of the innocent is his way of increasing his strength.
That's possible. But it's not only so he can drink human blood. He's also doing this to harden his heart. He's venting his monstrosity on innocent and defenseless people, and we're not going to allow this to continue. All of you get ready. We're going to find Sandrino and take the fight to him. You're the one hiding from us now. Where are you, Sandrino?
There's no point in hiding from justice. Just accept all the consequences of the evil things you've done. Come out and face me already. And face what is destined to happen to you.
I sent some moon chasers to check out all of Sandrina's known properties. And they didn't see even a single vampire.
I know Sandrino very well. He won't allow himself to appear weak in front of anyone.
You people are fools to ruin me like this. I am never going to forget everything that has happened. But that's not what's going to make me come out from hiding.
Sandrino's bound to show himself to us sooner or later. Let's just be patient and wait.
Guys, get ready. We need to trace where the call is coming from before he hangs up.
Hello? Sandrina's calling you right now? Yes, I'm ready.
Do you miss me, Sandrino?
I know you're also anxiously waiting for my call.
So tell me, did you like my present for you?
Oh, I like everything that comes from you, Asintha. You really know me so well.
Does this mean you're going to show yourself to me?
I know you can't wait to see me too, but I'm afraid you have to wait.
Why is that? Are you afraid of me?
You know that word is not in my vocabulary.
Let's put an end to this right now.
Why are you in a hurry? Don't you want to hear my soothing voice anymore?
Oh, you and I can talk all night long if you want, Sandrino.
Because you're right.
I am going to miss your voice. Especially when you're dead for good.
Who would have thought that even until death you would still give me hope? That there's a possibility for you and me to end up happy together.
Did you guys find the location? Okay, we're on our way there now.
Don't worry, Sandrino.
Because my face is the last thing you'll see.
I'll be waiting for the day you kill me.
Father, you're already at the location. Secure the whole area, okay?
That's not necessary.
Supremo's not here.
What?
However, we found
someone else here.
Who did you find?
It's Aaron.
He's gone, Malia.
It looks like the vampires tortured him to death.
Malia?
Yeah, I'm still here, Father. Go ahead and take his body with you. Let's all just meet back at the house.
I wanted to kill myself. I wanted to end my life. But when I learned you were alive, I found a little hope. Now it's my duty to protect you, Malia. There's a time to fight back. But for now, you should be more careful.
I swear I'm going to put an end to your killing spree, Sandrino.
Supremo?
You still haven't found Tristan?
We haven't let up on the search, Supremo.
Just do everything you need to do to find him.
Yes, as you wish.
You're not going to be able to find me until I have Tristan.
Father. Yeah, I'm on my way back. Yes, Father. Father, hold on. Let me call you back later.
Hurry up, guys.
Malia?
Why? What happened?
Well...
Is something going on outside?
The other moon chasers need your help outside.
Stay right here. I'll take care of it, Piolo. Hello?
Well, Malia, do you like my surprise? Do you know what those beautiful lights remind me of?
No, what?
The time when we were at that rooftop.
And we were just peacefully staring at all the city lights.
Malia, that was the very day I made a promise to you. That I'd keep on fighting no matter what.
Because I know that you're with me.
Even if we're far away from each other right now and a lot is happening. My Christmas isn't sad or lonely. Because I'm talking to the woman I'm going to love for the rest of my life.
Thank you so much, Tristan. Thank you for everything. Thank you that you're staying strong despite what happened.
Malia, if it's for you, there's nothing in this world I can't handle.
I promise you, Tristan, that in our next Christmas,
we won't be just talking over the phone.
You and I are going to be together. As well as the next Christmas. And the one after that.
And then the one after that.
And all of the Christmases.
And all the Christmases.
I love you very much, Tristan.
I love you too very much, Malia. And you and I are both going to fight until the end.
Sure that if Tristan was here, he'd give you something even more beautiful. It's sad that he's not with us right now, but look at what he did. He still found a way to show his love for you despite his absence.
I'm a very lucky girl to have met Tristan Profti. He's someone who doesn't only fight for himself, but more often than not, he fights for everyone's sake.
You know, Malia, the world is luckier to have both you and Tristan. Because not only do you risk your lives to fight for the sake of the greater good, but in the middle of this kind of dangerous situation, you two showed everyone that love can still blossom and hope can abound as well.
While there are people in this world like you, Profti, that supports our cause and is willing to fight, there is always going to be hope. A very peaceful Christmas to you, Profti.
A peaceful Christmas to you, Malia.
While waiting for the Lord Sentinel to arrive, I just want to remind you guys of our duties tonight, so listen up. We're going to continue patrolling the town for any possible attacks. We must make sure that everyone's safe from Supremo.
Virgil and I will go to the nearest police station and ask around. We might be able to get information on where Supremo is hiding.
Ben and I are assigned to the plaza. Danielle and the other Lunas will also patrol the area, since a lot of families spend their Christmas there.
I'm afraid nowadays, we no longer know where Supremo will stage his attack.
There may be a looming danger to humanity out there. But despite knowing this, I'm still glad that protecting the innocent is our way of giving this Christmas. I'm proud to be part of this group of amazing people.
Now is as good a time as any for us to remember our cause, to remember why we continue to fight this battle. It's because we all want to make this world a peaceful place for everyone in it. A world without violence or wars, or shedding of innocent blood. I want you to remember that this is the true meaning of this day. To have faith in everything that is good. I want to use this time to thank all of you, and also your colleagues in the Moonchasers that are no longer with us today. Because you guys are bravely giving up your own lives in order to fulfill your duties. And that is to create the peaceful world we all dream about. A kind and peaceful world for us and our loved ones. Moonchasers. Let's band together for our values, for our principles, and our reason for fighting.
Given everything we all went through, and are still going through to this day, I didn't expect we'd still be able to arrange a small party like this. That's why I think this is the right time for us to give honor, and celebrate the lives of the colleagues we lost in our fight. To both Veruska and Aaron, let us all remember how these two lived their lives, as well as their great contributions in fighting and defeating evil. And I also want to thank all of you for everything. Thank you for still being here with us, and for continuing to fight beside me in this war.
It is our sworn duty to help you, Lord Sentinel. We would never have had the courage to fight against Supremo if it wasn't for your leadership.
All of us here are so proud to have you as our Lord Sentinel.
Malia, I want this nightmare to end. I just want to live freely with my whole family again. I'm going to fight by your side.
Eventually be yours, for you to do as you please.
I'm afraid it wasn't Sandrina we were able to track. It was actually Aaron. Aaron's gone, Jacinta. The LLU took his remains back to their base.
I swear we're going to make Sandrino pay for every life he's going to take. I need to hurry up and find a way to flush him out. I'm going to help Malia defeat him.
In exchange, I grant unto you protection. against the strongest weapons of our enemies. You will not be hurt by Silver or by werewolf fangs. For as long as the blood of the vampire race is coursing through your body, you will not possess any weaknesses.
How often does that happen to you?
It just happened again.
Asinta, what you have is the exact same poison that kills werewolves after being bitten by a vampire. Before they become monsters. And I know that you're a vampire, but you also have a high percentage of werewolf blood in you. I have a suspicion that you're not like the other werewolves who've been bitten by vampires because you are able to hold yourself back from becoming a monster. I have no idea why. However, I think that's only possible if you were Leah. Tell me, are you really Leah? Well, it no longer matters to me what or who you really are. What's important is you get well.
Difficult to explain it, Theodore. But thank you for your help.
Thank you, Prof. The Moon Chasers informed Prof. T about the cursed ink appearing on Tristan's body.
Do you think this is connected to the prophecy?
I'm really hoping it doesn't, Father. I need to go see Tristan right now to be sure. I hope Sandrina had nothing to do with this. Gael, Vito, I'm going to need your help. I want to be absolutely sure that no one follows me going to Tristan's safe house.
We'll take care of it, Lord Sentinel. Vito and I will follow you.
Lord Sentinel, Diolo helped me so that you can gain access through the security camera surrounding the safe house. He's also finding ways to help us access the CCTV cameras on the possible routes towards the safe house.
Thanks, Lemuel. Father, please update me at once if you receive a report about Sandrino. Let's go.
Hey, Aunt Betty. You still haven't reacted to the stuff Duff and I bought for you. Did you really like everything we got? Are you all right, Aunt Betty?
I'm just thinking about you, Apple.
But you're the one getting married, right?
I'm thinking that maybe it'd be better for you if you stayed with your grandparents for now.
Huh? You want me to leave you?
Look, I just think it would be much safer for you to be with them in the province.
But what about you?
I'm going to stay here with your brother, Tristan.
But what about your wedding? Don't you want me to be your maid of honor anymore?
What's important right now is what her family is going through. Do you understand?
Go stay with them, Apple. This is better for you. You'll be safe there. It's fine to postpone our love lives for now. But just keep in mind that family should always be our priority.
Okay, Aunt Betty.
Tristan.
Leo.
Yeah?
About what happened last night.
I hope you don't take this the wrong way, but we called it into Prof. T.
Didn't you guys get scared?
Scared? No. I was just worried Supremo might have done something to you last night.
Leo, aren't you afraid it might turn into a monster like him?
Okay, I'll admit that I was surprised. It's the first time I've seen anything like it. But I know you, Tristan. I mean, given everything you did for us and for the other moon chasers, I know you're not going to change just like that. Because you're true to your cause for the greater good. And we trust you wholeheartedly.
Thanks for that, Leo.
Tristan, you have a visitor.
Betty?
Hmm?
It's like the universe really wants us to get married. Look at this. We were able to arrange all the documents in time. It's such a huge help that we have a lot of friends inside, especially the mayor.
They're doing a mass wedding.
Oh, this? It's mayor's initiative. It's for tomorrow.
They didn't stop you from coming in here?
It's much better if I'm the one who goes to you, rather than for you to leave the safe house. I made sure that no one was able to follow me. Are you sure you're okay? What happened to you?
Malia, it's the cursed ink. It appeared on its own last night. It doesn't stay long on my body, it's just there for a while. But I can't control it either.
Because you're not inherently evil. Jetra discovered something new from the ancient book of cursed spells. He learned that the cursed ink is actually the source of Suprema's evil all along.
But he told me the cursed ink is a form of protection. That's why I survived in my mother's womb back then.
That is not what Jetra told me. He said that the cursed ink can consume the goodness in a person's heart. That ink corrupts you and makes evil intentions dominate over everything. Intentions like hatred and anger. I think the reason why it's not fully manifesting on you is because you're not consumed by rage the way Sandrino is. But I'm afraid the moment the cursed ink fully manifests in you, we can no longer stop it from happening. You might turn evil for good, Tristan.
What is it?
Do you want us to join the mass wedding?
This wedding? Betty, are you saying that we're going to get married tomorrow?
Yes, Doc. You said it yourself, remember? The universe really wants us to get married.
Are you sure about this? You're really going to be my wife tomorrow?
Tristan, I'm just telling you all of this so that it can be avoided.
But Malia, I'm a human being. I can't avoid getting angry and feeling resentful. That's impossible.
Yes, I know. But I also know that you're someone who will never let evil prevail. That's how you're different from Sandrino. Because he let the cursed ink consume him completely.
My mother, Lydia, gave this to me some time ago, so I'd have something to remember them by. So I won't forget who I am and what my duty is. Mother was right. Because every time I see this pendant, I remember my loved ones and what they mean to me. And every single time I remember them, I remember who I am and why I fight. I hope this pendant also helps you, the way it helped me when I felt lost and confused. That in the event you forget, I hope it reminds you of those you hold dear and those who love you. We can do this, Tristan. We just have to believe we can.
As long as it's you, Malia, I'm going to believe it.
What? You don't want to come?
Come on. Of course we want to, Doc. Where is it anyway? I'm sure you're going to need a best man there.
You need a best man in a mass wedding?
You guys are just going to be witnesses. Come on.
It's hard when we don't see you for a long time. It's only been a few weeks. And here you are, getting married.
Well, of course. I'm telling you, the love Betty and I share is that intense.
We'll be sure to attend, Doc. All right?
Definitely.
We promise. Where will it be held?
Just go straight to the multi-purpose hall in San Ildefonso. You won't miss it.
Where, Doc? What did he say?
I heard him say San Alfonso. There's a multi-purpose hall there, too.
Doc, did you say San Alfonso?
Bogart? Hello? Hello?
Doc, I'm here. Is it San Alfonso?
Yeah, that's it.
Oh, I know where that is. It's near the green car. Yeah, we're going to be there.
Okay, you guys better be there.
You can count on us, Doc.
And are you sure about this?
Why don't you like Doc for me? Because if you don't, then...
It's not that. I really like him for you. But isn't it too soon for the wedding? Tomorrow, really?
Tristan, this is the only way I can think of to show Doc how much I really love him. That I want to be with him regardless of what's going on in my life.
Aunt Betty, you don't need to ask for my permission to get married. I mean, I've always wanted you to have a family of your own. You've been taking care of me and Apple for years now.
Thank you so much, Tristan. Tristan, I know that sigh anywhere. Don't worry about me, all right?
And I just want to give you the nice wedding you deserve.
Tristan, what's really important is that Doc and I are together.
All right, Aunt Betty. I'm going to the wedding.
Are you sure about that? Wouldn't it be dangerous?
Aunt, you know that I wouldn't miss your special day for the world.
Thank you, Tristan.
Hey, what's with the long face?
Doc wouldn't be with us in the auto shop anymore. Our group wouldn't be complete.
Oh, come on. You sound like Doc's your boyfriend. Listen, even if he marries Betty tomorrow, this auto shop is still our livelihood, Porky.
I guess you're right. Tristan is probably happy to hear that Betty is getting married tomorrow.
Of course he'll be happy. You know, I actually miss that guy. But don't worry. I'm sure we're going to see Tristan there at the wedding tomorrow, right? Hey, why are you still sad?
I'm supposed to be the one to buy our gift for tomorrow, but I don't have any money.
That's why. No wonder you're so sad right now. Don't worry about it. If you can't find a way, Doc wouldn't get mad even if we don't have a wedding gift. What's important is for us to be there when the priest says, "You may now kiss the bride."
Yeah!
That's the best part of a wedding, am I right?
Malia, I need to go to the wedding tomorrow. Because out of all of us, I'm the only one who can attend.
I understand what you feel, Tristan. I also know that you haven't seen Miss Betty for a long time. But I'm just really worried about your safety.
Yes, I know. That's why I'll agree to whatever conditions Prof T will set. I just need to attend Aunt Betty's wedding, Malia.
But Tristan...
Malia, even just for a few minutes.
This is really important to Aunt
Betty. I can't miss her special day.
All right, fine. I'll talk to Prof about it. I'll find a way to make this work.
Thank you so much, Malia.
Tristan and I already talked about the wedding tomorrow. I suggested to him that they should just hold the wedding here, and we'll make all the arrangements for them. But you know Tristan. He refused the offer. So I just left strict instructions to the Moonchasers that no one is to know about his transportation arrangements.
I've also informed my other colleagues at the LLU that they need to stand watch tomorrow at San Ildefonso.
I'm very confident that the Moonchasers can take the vampires on. It's Sandrino I'm worried about.
And unfortunately, we haven't found him yet. But we haven't stopped looking.
That's what I'm wondering about. This may be the longest period that Sandrino has gone into hiding.
Broth?
Sandrino's holding a press conference?
He and Jacinta will face each other off. Where is she now?
I'm going to talk to Jacinta first.
We'll take care of things here, Prof. T. I'm going to need all of the chances I can get to fight against Sandrino again.
We're closed for today. Just come back tomorrow. Oh, Miss Beautiful. We're actually open 24 hours. Do you want to get your oil changed? We also repair a car's exhaust and do body repairs.
Tell me where Tristan's aunt is getting married tomorrow.
In San Alfonso. At a mass wedding. At the multipurpose hall.
When it comes to female customers, Bogart goes weak in the knees.
You won't remember anything about what I asked you.
And he got a kiss! Bogart, who's that woman? The one in black? You even got a kiss!
Wait, what?
The woman you were talking to!
What woman? There was no woman!
She even kissed you on the cheek!
There was a kiss? You're full of nonsense. Come on and help me close the shop.
Betty? I don't want to do this to you, but I have to say goodbye for the meantime.
Hmm?
You and I shouldn't see each other for tonight.
Hmm?
Well, you know, that thing all old people say about weddings. It's bad luck for the bride and groom to see each other on the night before the wedding ceremony.
You really believe in that, Doc?
And what's wrong if I believe it in? Look, it's just a small sacrifice on our part. It's just for one night, Betty. And after we get married tomorrow, we will be together forever.
We can change the rules, you know. Mm-hmm. You said it yourself just now. In just a few more hours, you and I are going to be together. Mm-hmm. So what's the difference if you and I are together now and being together after the wedding?
Are you sure about this? You know what? You have a good point. Betty's getting married tomorrow?
That's right, Supremo. There will be a mass wedding in the multipurpose hall of San Alfonso.
I'm sure my beloved little brother is not going to miss this wedding. Order some of my followers to go there. Because they'll surely need more people to witness this beautiful event.
As you wish, Supremo.
And after Tristan joins our side, he's already there. He should indulge himself. Because it's not appropriate to have the guests go home hungry, right?
Tristan's not in danger for now. What if Sandrino really is the reason the cursed ink is appearing on Tristan's body? Whatever the reason may be, I need to hurry up and find Sandrino. Tristan and the rest of mankind will only be safe if I defeat him once and for all.